The key to happiness is really where we focus our mind, where we focus our memory, our use of memory. And as long as our mind is focused on the past, we are reinforcing a belief system of separation, which does prevent us from experiencing consistent happiness or constant happiness. And so you might say that the whole point of spiritual awakening is to become fully conscious, that as long as you have some beliefs that are hidden from awareness, they dictate your decisions. So you may think you're a human being making these free decisions every day of what to do, where to go, but actually it's this unconscious shadow that is dictating these decisions. And these decisions in a lifetime could be called the script of the world. And oftentimes human beings have a tendency as well to believe that they have free will. And free will is associated with the power of choice. But choice is a concept that was made up. There's no choice in heaven, there's no choice in nirvana, because oneness has nothing to choose between. It's just a state of pure beingness. So choice is a concept that was made up, and as long as you have unconscious or hidden beliefs, then you might say choice is arrested by the ego. Wasn't there like an HBO? Arrested development. You might say that life, so-called life in this world, is arrested development because it's being dictated by unconscious shadow beliefs. And there's no freedom in that. So that's why the goal is to become fully conscious, so fully aware, because as long as part of your mind is unaware, or we could say most of your mind is unaware like the iceberg, then you can't experience that joy and freedom in a consistent manner. So as we go deeper, we'll start to see that that the energy of happiness and joy and love is so important. And then the ego is just this insidious unconscious belief system which could taint the all these amazing holy encounters with a little bit of hesitation. So when we get identified with being a human being, we certainly encounter what seems to be deceptive, manipulative people. But if we really say, oh, you know, I'm not going to just take the common sense of, oh, it's them, and how do I deal with them, I'm going to bring it back to I just like to use the phrase, if you spot it, you got it. Especially if you feel a reaction going on. If you spot it, then you've got it. If you perceive it, then you believe it. And it's just another mirror giving you an opportunity to say, maybe I should take another closer look at the roots of what I believe. Because it can't be that there's actually something outside of me that has the power to take my peace away. If the Source created me as peace, if Source created me as love, then it can't be that there's some image, some event, some situation, some circumstance that can take it away. Peace of mind is not circumstance dependent. Peace of mind is neither caused by circumstances and events and people, nor is it taken away. So you can see all you're really doing is you're reclaiming the power of your mind, of your consciousness, of your awareness. I know when I was growing up, when I was a child and when I was in school, I loved maps and I loved graphics and I loved drawing things. So at some point I did ask Jesus for a map of the mind. Give me a map of the mind, a map of consciousness, and he had me draw a bunch of concentric circles, and he said, now on the outer ring of the circles, that is your gross perceptual world. That's just this ever-changing world of images that are flickering by like shadows on a screen. and very much like a movie that you've given meaning to, and you call that life. You call that life on planet Earth, but that's just the outer ring of the mind, just the very outer reaches. And he said, underneath your perceptions is a ring called emotion. So, you know, if you have fear in your awareness, if you have fear in your consciousness, you still will perceive fearful events, fearful people, because that ring of emotion is projecting that world that you see. These things that you call mountains and oceans and even the buildings and even the bodies and the people and the animals, everything is projected out from this ring of fear. It's not love that makes the world go round. It's fear. And that's important. If we're going to heal, we have to get it straight. That was always what I was saying to Jesus, was give it to me straight. No color candy coating. Okay, I'm big enough now. Give it to me straight. So this ring of emotion is underneath the perceptual world. And he says you have but two emotions. One is love and one is fear. There's many derivatives. So peace, joy, happiness, self, bliss, all things are derivatives of love, and guilt and shame and pain and hurt and all kinds of things. Jealousy, envy, on and on and on are derivatives of fear. So we need to purify that ring of emotion for us to see a peaceful world. We will not have a peaceful perception until we have harmony within. He says, when you want only love, you will see nothing else. Wow. That's the positive correlation of that ring. If you want only love, you will see nothing else. That's enough to motivate us to look inside and to purify the heart and to purify our thoughts and to have the Holy Spirit come and flood us, literally, or flood our mind with love and light.